Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the beginner series here at BusyWorksBeats.com, where we guide you through step-by-step in the production process. So today we're going to go over EDM Trap using only FL Studio plugins, and I'm going to simplify it as much as possible without getting too deep into advanced explanations. So first, let's start with drums and sound selection. So EDM Trap is really about mangling normal sounds and making them sound quirky, and I'll show you a couple techniques as to how to do that. So first, let's set our tempo to about 140 BPM. That's a nice trap tempo. So let's open up our browser here. Let's go to packs, and I'm going to look for quirky sounds to inspire sound design. So let's go to drums by Mode Audio. This is the update for FL Studio 12.2. It's free if you're a full member image line. Let's go to, let's start with percussion first, because that's where usually you find weird sounds. We're going to look for more belly sounds, like this one, and I'll show you how to mangle it without getting too complicated. Let's right click, go into open a new channel. First, I want to play it at a lower pitch, just to hear different tones. Next, I'm going to go to the wrench tool. We're going to turn on what's called portamento. This means it will pitch bend between two notes when I play different notes. So that's one way to come up with a cool kind of trap, a weird trap sound, just adding portamento. Now turning up the slide meter will change the way it bends pitch. Let's send this to track one. Let's open our mixer. In the mixer, we can add more effects like reverb. Let's add Fruity Reverb 2. We're going to crank up the wet level. Turn out our stereo separation. Turn down your decay time so the reverb is going to hit and then stop. And then also give it a nice pre-delay. And that's the type of sound we get. And you can also try stretching the sample. I'm not going to get into what stretching the sample is. And resampling it back so it's a little elongated. Let's try lower pitches. So that's where I like to start, with weird percussion and playing it at different pitches and running it through its own effect. Now I'm also going to add Fruity Delay after the reverb, and I'm going to have it on a very small feedback similar to the reverb here. I'm going to turn it on ping pong mode on pan. Set the time to about 2 or 4 steps and have the feedback so that we only hear the left and right, and then let it die out. And now we have a super unique type of sound. Now I'm going to add another reverb. This Fruity Reverb is going to be monophonic, so I'm going to pull the stereo separation to the right to make it monophonic, and I'm going to give it a nice decay time. In this one, you can experiment with how much bass you want to add. I'm going to add a long pre-delay. So it fills up a lot of space. You could turn down the wet level accordingly. Okay, so that's how we get these really quirky sounds to start off with. Now let's go into regular drums. So let's go back to our browser. Let's go to kicks. I'm going to find a nice punchy kick, and I'm going to layer it with a Legacy 808. So this one's pretty punchy, straightforward. Let's right click, go to open a new channel. Send that to track 2. Let's go to our snares from Mode Audio. Let's go to snares. And we're going to look for more of a hard trap sound, not like the EDMs. Snare. This one's okay. It's kind of a blend of EDM / hardcore southern trap. You can layer it with that as well. So you pick the snare you like. Okay, there's no right or wrong snare. Okay, so I'm not going to spend all day on this snare. Let's grab a hi-hat. We're looking for a closed hi-hat. The first one I like a lot, so let's open that in a new channel. Send that to track 5. So sound selection is a skill. So this is not something menial. This is actually a skill set. Let's find an open hi-hat that goes tss. Has a longer decay time. There we go. Let's right click, open that new channel. Send that to track 6. Now we're going to look for a cymbal for the downbeat so we have a little more impact with our kicks. I'm going to look for more of a that type of straightforward crash. Okay, and what else do we need? We have the kick, the snare, the crash, the cymbals. It's pretty much what we need for a trap. Okay, you can add more percussion as you like. So let's start with our kick and our snare rhythm. Trap is very specific as to the drum rhythms you use. We're going to be producing what's called half time. So instead of the 2 and the 4, we're going to put the snares on the 3 and the 7. If you don't know how to count music, go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. So the snares are going to go on the 3 and the 7. So according to the metronome, every 2 beats is really 1 beat. So a very common rhythm is a dance rhythm. Boom, boom, ch, boom, 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 ch. Very common, and that's very dancey as well. So let's use that. Now for the kick, I want it to have a shorter body. So let's click on the kick and just turn up your out parameter. This will create a fade out. So the kick's a little bit shorter and doesn't have as long of a body. So now we have our kick and our snare. Let's layer the snares. I want the longer tail, this one, to be a little more delayed. Let's go to our wrench tool, turn up time shift. This will delay this sample behind the metronome. So it sounds like it has a longer tail. Let's go to our mixer, turn down the volume for that snare. Everything does not need to be loud. Let's add this into the playlist by right clicking your pattern icon. Go to pattern 1, add that in. I'm gonna change my snap to grid to bar mode, switch it to song mode as well. So now we have our drums laid out, very simple drums. Okay, I don't like to add the 808 until last. A lot of people like to start with an 808, but they don't realize they're locking themselves in musically. Okay, so let's go to pattern 2. Let's create our hi-hat rhythms. We have a whole video on hi-hat rolls and different things. I'm not going to dig too deep into hi-hat rolls right now. I'm going to keep it fairly simple. Let's add our hi-hats in. Let's right-click, fill each 2 steps. That's an easy way to start. Do that again. Now, easy hi-hat rolls are just adding notes closer to each other in the step sequencer. So let's clone this and let's create a faster hi-hat roll. So pattern 2 and pattern 3 are going to be playing off each other back to back. Let's zoom in a bit. Close out the browser so we can see what's going on. So pattern 3, it's going to go pattern 2, pattern 3, pattern 2, pattern 3. You can make as many variations as you want. That's why I like to separate elements into different patterns. Let's hit shift so we can duplicate those over, or you can hit control B as long as it's locked to the grid. If you don't have it locked to the grid, control B can get messy. Pattern 3, let's right click, go to piano roll. Now right here where I have that note, I'm going to delete it and I'm going to just extend that note before it. Okay, so let's highlight it and drag it out. Let's go to snap to grid. I'm going to change it to a half step or a quarter step, and I'm going to hit control U. That will chop it up into pieces. And the hi-hat roll kind of ends abruptly for me, so I'm going to get rid of that second note. I'm going to duplicate the roll. So I'm hitting control to highlight and shift to duplicate to make the roll longer. I'm going to keep it very basic as far as the hi-hats. Let's go back to our mixer. The hi-hat does not need to be the loudest element in the mix. Let's turn that down. So now we have a dance vibe. We haven't really trapified it yet, so let's go to pattern 4. Let's add that open hi-hat. So during the hook, you can add energy by adding the hi-hats on the ands, like 1 and 2 and. Now for this hi-hat, it has a lot of transient energy, so I'm going to go to what's called the envelope, activate it for the volume, give it a little attack. So let's lower that attack. I mean, let's increase the attack a bit. So it doesn't hit, it goes instead of, like a T sound, it gives us a smooth S, 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 instead of T, T. So we're getting rid of that sharp transient. This is to add energy during a hook. turn it down in the mix. It does not need to be the loudest element in the mix. Let's add the cymbal for the downbeat. So in my head, I hear the bass going boom, 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 boom. So let's do that. Let's go to our browser. Let's collapse it so you see what's going on. Let's go to PAX, go to Legacy, go to Drums, and go to Vintage. These are samples from an 808 kit. Let's grab the second bass drum two. Let's right click, open in new channel. First thing we need to do is tune the sample. We have a whole video on how to tune your samples in ADAW. It's on YouTube. Let's right click. Let's go to edit. Let's go to the marker tab. Let's go to detect pitch regions. This will tell us the key of the sample. Now this is a rough estimate. Okay, it's not the pure tuning. It's at G. We just know it's in the key of G. G has many different frequencies associated. So watch that video to learn how to fully tune. We even have another video update called How to Tune Your 808s, How to Create 808 Slides. Now we're going to go to your envelope tab, reset your root note, and right click on G. If you mess up, hit reset. Right click on whatever it told you the note was. It does not matter if it's G4, G5. It's just the same note in a different octave, meaning higher or lower pitch. So let's send this to the mixer, track 8. So let me give it the notes that I had in my head. Boom, boom, boom. So let's right click, go to piano roll. I like to program my 808s in a higher octave first so I can hear what's going on tonally. Let's turn this down so we don't clip like we just did. Now this 808 is not very elongated. That's why we have at busyworksbeats.com 808 Science Drums. Okay, so for example, I'm just showing you alternatives. So as this loads up, there's about over 40 808s. You know, you get those industry standard 808s. There are more to 808s than just the sub bass. Okay, so anyway, let's go to Legacy Drums, Vintage, and that's where we got the first 808. So let's collapse the browser. Let's add pattern 6 into the playlist. Let's call this the 808. And let's add the higher pitch note, and then we're going to drop it down later. So I want to go boom, 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 boom. You can hear it's kind of hard to hear the tone. That's why I like to pull it up an octave, hitting control up. See, if I didn't pull it up an octave, I would have left it at C sharp. It's really D. I'm going to clone this and come up with an alternative to that rhythm. Pattern 7, that's going to end it out. Let's change this to pattern 7. Then I want to go dun, 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 dun. So let's... So now we can lower things down an octave. I'm going to hit control down twice. Let's go back to pattern 6, hit control down twice. So now we're playing those sub octaves for the 808. Now this 808 is a specific type of 808. I might swap it out because it's not giving me the feel I want. So let's go back to the browser and I'll give you the sample for free from busyworksbeats.com. Under 808 Science Drums, I'm going to load up 808 Carbon. So you're going to get the project files. Now I know this needs to be tuned to A, and it gives you a little more life than that other sample. So in music, you usually don't start right away with the 808. You let the song kind of build up. So let's swap the sections here. Since that has all the elements, let's start with lesser elements and then let it build up into the chorus. So let's cut out the drums, cut out the bass. And we need music, so let's start building out the music here. Let's add another element. Let's add FL keys. I'm going to show you how to transform these from basic keys to something pretty cool. Send it to track 9. Let's switch it out for grand piano 3. of underrun here, so let's crank up the buffer a little bit. Let's come up with a melody for the piano. Trap music, they like to copy a lot of horror-like melodies. So let's go to pattern 8. Let's right-click, go to piano roll. And I'm going to do this just by whatever my mind's telling me, okay? There's a lot more to melody than just this. So we're going to start on the same note as if we were playing the 808, which was A. So a lot of half steps involved in melody for the horror feel. Let's drag that out. The melody doesn't have to be super elongated either. Instead of going up a half step, we go down a half step. So the half step is very utilized in trap music. Now let's go to FL keys, let's go to the wrench tool, give it a little time shift, because right now it's too on the grid. Let's go to our mixer, let's add a little reverb to make this seem more realistic. I like to pull the reverb mono for piano, just for a cooler effect. Turn up your decay. Give it a little pre-delay. So it sounds cooler than just the dry signal. But don't forget we made that quirky sound. We're going to add that in as well. Let's change up the drums a bit. Instead of making it dancey like this, I'm going to change up the kick a little bit. Southern part, let's add the EDM part, which is to add those quirky melodic elements. So now let's add in the EDM melody by using our quirky pitch bending percussion here. Now it's not tuned, so we have to go by ear. Okay, it's a big difference. You can hear it's a little out of tune compared to the keys. So this is why tuning is so important. If I didn't pitch it up, it would sound out of key, even though I'm playing the right key. Okay, it sounds out of key, but I'm playing the right key. It's just that it's out of tune. That's why tuning is incredibly important. Let's come up with a quirky percussive melody. You can also push the piano to the back so it's not so up front. Let's do that. A lot of EDM 808s also don't change pitch a lot. They're trying to keep a steady frequency. Let's add this quirky melody in, pattern 9. Let's come up with a cool... Again, this is not tuned, so we're not following a scale. The musical notes don't mean anything because they're not playing the same exact note. So remember, portamento is activated, so you have to kind of keep clicking the note to hear the actual pure tone because it's pitch bending. Keep it fairly simple. I'm going to turn the portamento down a little bit more. Also, we're going to give it time shift so it's not on the downbeat perfectly. I'm going to turn off the 808 so you don't hear all that excess bass. to control down. This should be D sharp. To control down. You hear it sounds completely different, an octave lower. Oh, you know what? I hit. Okay. That's why you want to check different octaves. Gives you a different perspective of pitch. Let's turn it down in the mix. Get rid of the piano. Piano seems a little too on the grid. Let's give it a little more time shift. Let's also take off the monitor support so you don't hear all this excess bass, and we can hear more frequency clarity over the headphones. Start over. So stuff is too loud, like the cymbal, a little too loud over the headphones. Also, you want to think about panning. I'm going to pan the hi-hats left, pan the piano a little right. Let's add a little reverb to the hi-hats as well, fruity reverb. Turn down the wet level. Turn up the kick a bit. Also, I'm going to add an EQ to the kick, parametric EQ2. Boost up some of that low end. Notice the 808 is not the loudest element. Kick is louder than the 808. I think we need to swap out the snare. That's the only problem I have right now. Let's go to browser, drums by mode audio. Let's go to snares and pull up more of a trappy, like a southern trap snare, not these dance snares. They just don't fit the mood right now. Let's try these. See how they fit. A little shorter in decay. A little lacking in the low end. But that's a mixing issue that I'm not going to get into right now. So at this point, you can add more synthesizers if you want to make it more EDM-esque. But right now, I mean, it's fitting the mood properly. Let's add a horror type of synth. Let's open up GMS. Go to Banks, User, Default. And I'll show you how to program a vibrato lead, which is very horror-esque. So right now, it's just a sawtooth. What we want to do is add an LFO for the pitch. So let's go to destination, let's go to frequency, and an LFO will modulate the pitch. If you don't know what that means, you can go to busyworksbeats.com/sounddesign. We have a free course on sound design for you. Let's turn up our LFO amount, and let's turn up, slow down our rate. So now the pitch is going, okay. It's a very haunted sound. Now I'm going to pull the voices up to 2, pull them stereo, pull the detune in a bit. Okay, and let's activate oscillator 2 and pull it down negative 12 semitone. So we have a nice layer. Let's go to the wrench tool, activate portamento and monophonic, turn your pitch glide up a bit. So now it's smooth transitions between the notes. I just pulled up one sync, meaning we're FM synthesizing one to one. Gives me more harmonic activity. So a little advanced, but let's go to the mixer here for track 10. Let's open up a Fruity Reverb 2. Again, you're going to get the project file. So if something gets complicated, no worries. Let's just keep moving. Give it a little reverb. Cut out that low end. As a lead tone or just something to complement the piano. Let's do it using two different things. First, starting out the intro, I'm just going to have it use half tones, remember, or half steps. That's the secret to the haunted sound. Let's right click, go to piano roll. So we're only going down a half step, E to D sharp. We're gonna have that repeat in the playlist. Turn down the volume. Let's see if we can add some vocal chants in here. Let's collapse the structure. Let's go back to packs. Let's go to vocals and let's try to find something that goes. I know that doesn't sound, you might have to record your own kind of chant. These aren't really chants, these are just vocal phrases. Come on, do it for, don't spit, give me, give it, hey. I don't think a female will work for this.
Baby.
House. I remember. I was improvising.
I would like.
It's a smack jacket.
Okay, let's, we need it.
And we
rock me.
Respect. So, spin it.
That's
you and me.
What time?
You and me.
What time is it? What time?
So I'm going to get him saying what. Let's right click, open that new channel. Right click, go to edit. It's going to pull up Edison. We're going to highlight where he's saying what.
What?
Let's grab that. Bring it back into the sampler.
What? 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 What?
We can play different pitches. Take Control L. Send this to the mixer automatically. I'm going to pull up a parametric EQ2 to cut out the low end. We're going to change this shape to a high pass shape by left clicking, changing the band shape.
What?
Has a lot of low end. So
what?
Let's,
what? What? What?
Let's cut out that low end. And play lower keys on our keyboard. Let's spice this up a bit. Let's add another plugin called Fruity Stereo Enhancer. Pull up the phase offset. Now at the end here, go what, you know, that at the end. So let's highlight the sample. And you can use the fade out knob to get rid of that tail end noise. So I like that what chant. So let's right click. Actually, let's not right click it yet. Let's go to channel rack, pattern 11, boom. It's gonna go on the ands. One, and, two, and. Let's right click, go to piano roll, and pull the note down to G. So now it plays that deeper voice rather than playing middle C. Let's add the vocal chant into the playlist. Add that during the main verse and hook. Now it's a little too lagged to me, for me. What you can do, this is a little more advanced. Highlight all the patterns. Go to your playlist, snap to grid, change it to none. Then you wanna hit, highlight all the patterns here and hit shift left twice, or in increments of 2, 1, 2. That will micro shift the whole pattern. You can see it's not lined up to the grid anymore. Okay, because it moved it off the grid a little to the left so that it can be heard a little bit earlier. I like that better. sound more aggressive, you can add Fruity Wave Shaper. Turn down your post level before you start messing with Fruity Wave Shaper. Trust me. Right click a point, and we're going to create this sort of square shape. It's going to sound very saturated and distorted. Aggressive tone, that's how you do it. I'm going to add Fruity Reverb 2, give it pre-delay, and give it a very low decay curve, very high wet level. Cut out the lows. You can do more pitch bending with that EDM melody element and make it more constant. For example, let's make this unique. I just left click on the top, make it unique. I'm going to have it do a lot of stutters and a lot of, you know, constant pitch. Let's change our snap to grid back to a bar mode. Zoom out. I'm hitting control, highlight the timeline to highlight loop area. So here on pattern 10, I'm going to have it go or something like that. So one, one, two, three, one, two, one, two, one, one, two, two, tum, tum, tum. So we're going to go back and forth. This is a little more advanced. Just follow along. Snap to grid. We're going to change it to 1/3 beat. So it does triplet notes. I'm going to change it back to quarter notes by going back to a half step for snap to grid. A little hard to hear the tone because of the pitch bend, so let's pull that down an octave, hitting control down. You can see in a higher octave it sounds different. That's why you gotta keep moving it. Switch between quarter times and triplet times. So I'm just going to copy this without switching the snap to grid. I'm just going to highlight by hitting control, left click and drag, hold shift, left click and duplicate. Turn that what down a little. Repeat it, and you could create change ups as you like. So right here, I'm going to drop it down an octave back to its original root note. The piano might be a little too much. Also, the reverb's a little heavy. Let's turn that down. Also, the pre-delay, a little long. Pull the pre-delay in a bit. I'm gonna get rid of reverb too, actually. Oh, you know what it is? The delay. Let's turn that off. I just want it to sound like it's in a small room. So that small pre-delay and that low decay time is what creates that illusion. Without it, also going to pitch the hi-hats down and give it an out perimeter to make them sharper. And I pitched up the open hi-hat. Technique. I'm gonna move everything down. Let's open up the fruity stereo enhancer. Let's pull up that phase offset for that percussive melody. Pull down the melody a bit, pull up the 808. Stereo enhancer technique. Give it a stereo width. Pull it down in volume. What's a little too early? I'm going to give it a little time shift. So we start off teasing the crowd. They're going to think it's just a typical trap beat from the South, and then we trip them up with the percussive melody. So it's all about contrast. So from here to here, we went from slow to fast, another contrast. Thank you. Okay, so there you have it. This continues the beginner series here at busyworksbeats.com/beginners. If you want to learn more about music theory, which expands into different genres, go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. Thanks for watching today. Please be sure to like the video and share with your friends so we can help more producers around the world. That's why we give these videos out for free, to help you. And hopefully you share them with your friends so we can help more producers around the world. It's busyworksbeats.com.